Hi, my name is Eric Magnuson, St. Bernard's class of 1995.
And I'm Sara Magnuson West, and I graduated from St. Bernard's in 1998. We have a lot of fond memories of St. Bernard's. It was such a family feeling when we went here many years ago, and we have a lot of really great memories and a lot of special people that we remember, and I think both of us made several lifelong friends going to school here.
I think it's pretty amazing to that point, just how many people I still keep in contact with from grade school, people whose weddings I've been to. You know, if you gave me the list of my 8th grade graduating class, I could probably give you everybody's first and last name to this day. So a lot of people think that's pretty unique. Friends of mine say, you know, I never had an experience quite like that, or I don't remember half the people I went to school with. Well, I think that, you know, St. Bernard's is definitely unique in the fact that, and, you know, correct me if I'm wrong, but, you know, we were friends and we knew everybody in the class, and we spent many years with most of those people, and, you know, a lot of those people, I see, like you said, to this day are still good friends of ours.
And it's been fun, too, with Facebook and other forms of social media, hooking back up with people that we went to grade school with, because it's almost like you left off where you pick up where you left off, and so that's been fun. I remember in the 90s, our principal was Mr. Peters, and my class was the last class to have him as the principal. He left in 1998, but he was a great principal. He knew all of the students, and he really made St. Bernard's what it was for me. Yeah.
I remember how excited we were to get our birthday pencils.
Oh.
You got a little St. Bernard's birthday pencil on your birthday, and when you had your weekly, you know, all the classes would gather in the gym, and we'd kind of have our announcements, if you will. You get called up.
It was a pretty big day when you're a kid
and you get called. Maybe not so much in junior high, but, you know, the years prior to that were pretty.
Yeah.
And just kind of to your social media point, too, right behind us here is where the old computer lab used to be. And when I was going to school here, we had maybe, I don't know, half a dozen computers or so, and they were all one single unit, except for one special computer, and you had to get permission to get on that computer. That was a separate monitor and actual computer component, but mostly green screen, and I think we had an orange screen one, one of which was donated by Goodrich Dairy. Remember that? The big placard was on there. And some of the things we did.
Oh, I remember Oregon Trail was the big thing to do in computer class. That was very exciting to play. I remember the printer, like the main
dot matrix.
Yeah, and you kind of share the edges off, and we made cards and all sorts of stuff in computer class. I don't remember any computers in the classrooms. I don't remember teachers having computers.
No, I don't think
computers.
That we did at that point, which is, you know, now I work on a computer every single day of my life.
Yeah,
most of us do, so it's just amazing to see, you know, in that amount of time.
How quickly things
change. And I'm sure the computer lab nowadays is would have blown our minds if we'd gone back in time to look at it then, so.
And it had air conditioning. I know that we had lots of hot days here at St. Bernard's, so it was a treat to go to the computer lab and have air conditioning.
It was, because, you know, to that point, too, we didn't get to wear shorts until I was...
that started in the 90s.
Well, that started in the 90s, being able to wear shorts to school, which was, obviously, we were big fans of that.
Mm-hmm.
And they also did a changeover on the outfits for the guys. They used to have to wear a light blue shirt. And I think people were having trouble finding children's light blue shirts at the time in the colors that they wanted, so they changed to white. So I went from my uniform had a changeover while I was here at St. Bernard's, and I think to this day it's still that way.
I think it's white and blue, yeah.
It's changed.
It's changed. Green and maroon.
Green and maroon? Yeah. Oh my goodness. Okay, well.
Okay.
Things continue to change at St. Bernard's School.
Girls wore... we had cute, well, I thought they were cute, red and gray and white plaid jumpers. You had to wear the jumper until you passed sixth grade. So I think back now, you know, a lot of schools wear skirts, but we had to wear the full jumper with the a white shirt until sixth grade, and then junior high girls got to kind of cut the top off and have a skirt. So that was...
Be rolling it too high.
Roll.
What happened?
Some things don't change, I guess. They still do that. So yeah, uniforms, we got to wear shorts. A lot of the girls ended up starting to wear shorts once that... So we had school sweatshirts. A lot of people.
We did have the school sweatshirt or the optional sweater, but you always wanted to wear a sweatshirt because that was kind of
the
cool thing to do if you had the option.
Sports
were big when we were here too. Soccer had really taken off, I think, in like the 80s, and you had a pretty large constituency of Catholic schools who were involved in soccer clubs. So I know you and I both played pretty extensively.
Mm-hmm.
And
our teams were good. St. Bernard's was
known
for having really good soccer teams. Intramural sports was really big. I remember fourth through sixth graders got to play intramural basketball, and that was really popular, and a lot of kids did that.
The pizza party would follow the final game. It was a big. It was pretty fun. It was really a good time. I mean, like you said, everybody would just be up here on the weekends
spent your Sundays or Saturdays
you did.
Here.
You did. So, I'm thankful to Mom and Dad for putting up with all that. They definitely put in their time here at St. Bernard's as far as, both sending their kids here and going to church here and spending all their extracurricular time here as well.
We had great coaches. I know you remember one of your coaches.
Mr. Rochon, who is also working as a custodian here for a while. Fantastic basketball coach. And I'll tell you, one heck of a strict fellow when it came to, getting your basketball skills down. His son John was a good friend of mine, and we played basketball together. Mr. Schoen worked out at Mom Michael's while coaching, so he had experience coaching some of the older kids, and we thought that was pretty awesome, having somebody with that much experience, in kind of guiding us and showing us what to do when we were in our formative years. But, yeah, he was, if you were a tall guy, which, obviously I wasn't, I was a guard, so I was okay there, but if you ever brought the ball down below your waist, you had to start doing laps. You know, it's like, there's no reason if you're a tall guy that you should ever bring the ball below your waist. You're just making guys like Eric be able to steal from you, so.
You had great coaches, and I had lots of great coaches,
Mr. Summers is a great soccer coach, and his kids both went on to play, in high school and college, too, and he was just a really nice guy, one of those guys that you just meet him and it was like, I don't think he had a mean bone in his body.
We had a lot of awesome teachers, and I love having the opportunity to come back to visit St. Bernard's and still see a lot of them here, and I think that shows how dedicated they are to the school, and I'm sure at this point they're probably teaching students own children that they've had in the past, and so I bet that's fun.
They obviously had an impact on you.
Well, yeah, and I did. I student taught here. I'm a teacher now, and I did choose to come back here and do my student teaching, and absolutely loved being back in the building and being back in the community. I know teachers that still teach here. We both had, did you have Mrs. Payton? You had Mrs. Payton.
I did, yep.
For science and
upstairs. We rotate sixth grade and started doing the rotation of classes to get you ready for what was to come.
She was a fantastic science teacher. We both had Miss Gallus, who's still here.
Yep, Miss Gallus was.
Junior high, she was fun.
I'll tell you what, when it comes to notes, Miss Gallus, she got you ready for what was to come because we took some pretty intensive notes. But when I got into high school, these people were struggling. I was like, like a half the notes I take in Miss Gallus' class. So we're good. But she was a great teacher and very dedicated to students and one of my favorites that I had at St. Bernard's, too.
I know Miss Lamoria is still here. We both had her.
Miss Lamoria, too.
I thought when you were going to say no passing, Miss Lamoria always caught us passing notes in class. We stuck them in hollowed out markers and would throw them across the floor, hoping that she wouldn't catch up, but she always did.
And talk about another just absolutely nice individual. I mean, Miss Lamoria I think at one time, Jake Benson and I, we were wrapping gifts for Christmas and we got into a little bit of, we started hitting each other with the empty tubes, and she wasn't too happy about that, so she sent us down to Mr. Peter's, you know, office. That was the only time I'd ever been sent to the office with some water, just for it. But no, I still see her to this day, and we left.
I just want to mention one more teacher. Miss Atkins was another teacher that comes to mind. I know she taught both of us, and she was here for many years. And she was a kindergarten and first grade teacher. And,
yes, had kids in our grades.
Patience of a saint. But I'm just so grateful to have been part of St. Bernard's community. I'm so proud that they have been around for 100 years, and I look forward to watching them continue to educate students for many years.
Absolutely. Like Sarah said, it's, you know, we had a great time growing up here in this community. You know, I wouldn't do it over, wouldn't trade it in for anything. It's exciting to see the school still, you know, walking into it to this day, and it feels like, you know, in certain respects, we point things out and say, oh, here's a few changes, but, you know, it's still good old St. Bernard's, and, you know, hopefully for many years to come, it will continue to be that way, and many more students will pass through these doors and have the same wonderful experience that you and I have. Thanks.
Happy birthday.
Okay.
Sorry,
you
just say happy birthday, St. Bernard.
Okay, all right.
Okay.
On three. One, two.
Happy birthday, St. Bernard.